Hello, my dear friends. My name is Alberto. I'm a developer advocate at Google working on efforts related to the AMP open source project. In this session, we are going to talk about building successful sites in WordPress powered by AMP. Google recently launched an initiative called Web Vitals with the goal of providing unified guidance for quality signals that are essential to delivering a great user experience on the web. These quality signals are combined into a ranking factor called page experience. The bottom line is this: all other things being equal, content with better page experiences should rank higher in search results because users will enjoy them more and will likely engage with them more. So the question is, how do we go about getting great page experiences for our pages on any website? The goal of optimizing page experiences is very well aligned with AMP's visions and design principles. From the beginning, AMP has been all about a simple action. Take care of the user experience and everything else will follow. This means that AMP was designed explicitly to be a powerful and cost-effective tool to make it easier for anyone to build sites that bring great page experiences to users, regardless of technical expertise or the amount of resources that we have to make that happen. And it turns out that the capabilities and design principles of AMP are especially useful in a CMS such as WordPress, where most users need and demand turnkey solutions for all the components needed to build their sites, including critical aspects such as performance and usability. For an ecosystem like this, AMP brings what I like to call great page experiences as a service. The question is, how can we take advantage of AMP in WordPress? And here is where the official AMP plugin for WordPress enters the game. This plugin is part of the overall AMP project, and it enables AMP content publishing in WordPress in a way that is seamlessly integrated with the standard publishing workflows of the WordPress platform. The AMP plugin provides many capabilities that you can take advantage of out of the box. It automates as much as possible the process of generating AMP valid markup, minimizing the amount of work that you need to do. It provides effective validation tools to help you deal with AMP incompatibilities if they happen, including tasks such as identifying issues, indicating which components of your site are causing them, and reporting them to you effectively. It also provides support for AMP development to make it easier to build AMP compatible ecosystem components, such as themes and plugins, and also full websites with AMP compatibility built in. And it allows the serving of AMP pages optimally via capabilities such as mobile redirection, AMP to AMP linking, minimization of AMP validation issues surfaced to Search Console, and serving of optimized AMP pages by default. So with all these capabilities, who is the audience for the AMP plugin? The good news is the AMP plugin can be beneficial to anyone regardless of technical expertise. For technically savvy users, such as developers, the plugin provides powerful and effective developer tools to help them do AMP development and build plugins and themes as well as full sites. For non-developers or less tech-savvy users, or if you simply don't want to deal with validation issues and tackle development tasks, the AMP plugin allows you to assemble fully AMP-compatible sites out of AMP components, and it helps you cope with validation issues in easy and effective ways. How do we use the plugin in practice? I'm glad you asked. The plugin provides three different configuration options for bringing the power of AMP to your website. Depending on the option that you choose, the plugin will use one or two sets of theme templates to render your content, and you may have either your whole site on AMP, or you may have an AMP version of your site and a non-AMP version of your site. We call this option template modes, and there are three of them. In standard mode, there is a single set of theme templates for rendering your content, and there is only one version for your site, the AMP version. This is the ideal configuration, as your whole site is served as AMP for both desktop and mobile visitors. And this is a great choice for sites where all components used, such as themes and plugins, are fully AMP compatible, or if you have resources to do some custom AMP development and fix AMP validation issues if they happen. Let's take a look at a site using this mode. The key thing to remember in standard mode is that your site uses a single theme and there is a single version of your site. And therefore, all of your content is served on AMP for both desktop and mobile visitors. For example, tol.org is a new site, simple or a very sleek site. We can see that the AMP validator Chrome extension is telling us that this site is powered by AMP. And because it is using standard mode, AMP will be served for all four factors and the site looks equally beautiful in all of them. This is the desktop version, has a nice layout. By the way, look at the GDPR cookie consent notice available. We can check also how it looks in the tablet format. Look equally nice, of course. And we can take a look at the smaller form factor. That's the phone. Nice layout. And here we can see that there is a hamburger menu, responsive menu, a bunch of categories, have a search bar, and they have even a donate capability, which is very nice. Can take a look also as a post. See that the article layout is done and it looks very beautiful. It has social sharing. And if we go all the way down, we can see that users also can comment on the articles. Basically, they have all the features they need for the users to get a great experience for the site, and everything is AMP. Another site that has been built using the AMP plugin in standard mode is the website for the AMP plugin itself. Again, it's not a complex site, but it's a beautiful design and it looks very snappy. By the way, you should check this site to learn more about the AMP plugin. You can find here good documentation about the plugin, how to get started, some playbooks, reference docs, and also the site has a showcase section that lists sites in the wild that are being powered by the AMP plugin in the different modes. There is also an ecosystem section that provides curated, non-exhaustive lists of plugins and themes that are known to be incompatible. And we recently added a section on AMP experts that are dev agencies and freelancers that do AMP development, and they are able and willing to help anybody that needs them. Again, the AMP plugin is in standard mode. It looks beautiful in all four factors. This is the desktop. You know, we saw the tablet format looks nice as well, and we can go to smaller form factors like a mobile phone. And here again, we have our hamburger menu. We don't have too much stuff here, but you know, we have a search bar, a download button, and so on. I hope these sites give you a small glimpse of what is possible when you use the AMP plugin in standard mode. In transitional mode, there is also a single set of theme templates for rendering your content, but in this case, there are two versions of your site. A non-AMP version, which can be served to visitors coming from desktop devices, and an AMP version, which can be served to visitors from either desktop or mobile devices. This is a good choice for sites that use a theme that is not fully incompatible, for example, but the functional difference between the AMP and non-AMP version are acceptable. This is also applies for plugins, by the way. And it is also a good choice if you have the capacity to do AMP development and you want to work progressively towards making your site fully incompatible and then switch to standard mode, the ideal case. Let's take a look at a site using transitional mode. The key thing to remember in transitional mode is that we get some of the same benefit of standard mode in terms of having a single fully responsive AMP theme. But in this case, there are two versions of your site, the AMP version and the non-AMP version. For example, here I have a site running locally. I am using 2020, which is the latest WordPress core theme. And I'm using Jetpack, which is a popular plugin that provides a wide range of functional modules. Many of them are incompatible, but not all of them are incompatible yet. So in particular, we are using social share buttons, in this case, Twitter and Facebook. And if we go to the footer, we are using two widgets, the Google Translate widget and one that is called the Milestones widget. We said that transitional mode may be used if we have a site where the theme and the plugins used are not necessarily fully incompatible, but the visual and functional difference between the AMP and non-AMP versions of your site are acceptable, or if you have resources to fix the differences and move towards standard mode. To see how far are we from standard mode, we can use a capability of the AMP plugin, which lets you do pair browsing when in transitional mode, so you can see the similarities and differences between both versions of your site. With pair browsing, you have on the left, you have the non-AMP version of your site, and on the right, you have the AMP version of your site. You can see that the social shared buttons look almost identical. There is just a standing issue on the link that can be fixed easily. And if we continue, if we scroll the site looks identical elsewhere. And in the widget, we notice that the Google Translate widget is not appearing in the AMP version. And that is because it uses custom JavaScript and that is not allowed and the plugin is stripping it out. And the milestone widget, it works, but in the non-AMP version, it updates via JavaScript frequently. And in the AMP version, it only updates when the page is reloaded. So here, we need to make an assessment and determine if we don't really need the pieces that do not work, and therefore we can avoid them, or determine that we do need them, and then we either stay in transitional mode and keep those pieces on the non-AMP version of our site, or we need to fix them. And fixing them means either finding a solution that is incompatible in the ecosystem or doing some custom development to make them happen. So this gives you an idea of the approach that must be followed if you use the plugin in transitional mode and move your way towards standard mode. In rhythm mode, there are two different sets of theme templates for rendering your content. And there are also two versions of your site, a non-AMP version, which again can be served to visitors coming from desktop devices, and an AMP version, which can be served to visitors coming from mobile devices. This mode may be selected if your site is using a highly AMP incompatible theme and you are not technically savvy, or when you simply don't want to deal with incompatibilities and prefer to have a simplified workflow to get AMP experiences to your users. Let's see an example of a rhythm mode site. Rhythm mode is similar to transitional mode in that there are also two versions of your site, but in rhythm mode, two different themes are used. We said that rhythm mode may be used if we have a site where the theme and plugins used are very much not AMP compatible. And while we should strive for the ideal standard mode configuration, we may not be able to switch to a more compatible set of components at this moment, but we still want to bring AMP-powered experiences to our users coming to us from mobile devices. For example, here we have a sample site running locally with a non-AMP compatible theme as the active theme. It is a neat site with a lot of structure and sections, a nice image carousel, sidebars, and so on. We can configure the theme to be used by the AMP version of our site in the settings screens of the AMP plugin. First, I can use what is called the AMP Legacy Theme, which is a very simple set of templates to serve baseline AMP experiences. Going back to the site, we see that the homepage does not have an AMP version because Legacy AMP only works on posts and pages. But if we click on an article, we land first on the non-AMP version, which can be served to visitors coming from desktop devices. But if we switch to the AMP version, it takes us to a simple but neat experience which can be served to users coming from the mobile devices. In rhythm mode, we also have the option of using any compatible theme as the theme for the AMP version of our site. For example, I can select the latest WordPress core theme 2020 as the theme for the AMP version of my site. And if we go back to the site, we can see that the homepage now has an AMP version as denoted by the Chrome AMP extension. And if we click in the same article as before, and we go to the AMP version of it, we can see that now we get the look and feel and functional capabilities of the 2020 core theme. It's a very nice layout. I have hamburger menu. I also have the search bar capability. And if we go back down, we see the social sharing, commenting capabilities, the whole nine yards. In addition to these configuration options, the plugin provides tools to make your AMP content publishing experiences as frictionless as possible. For example, with Flexible AMP, the AMP plugin gives you the flexibility to incorporate AMP into your site progressively. You can select which part of your site should be served on AMP and which should not with fine granularity. It also gives you mobile redirection, which means that when the plugin is configured in either transitional or rhythm mode, you can automatically redirect mobile users to the AMP version of your site so they get AMP experiences when they need it the most. And with mobile redirection, the plugin automatically enables AMP to AMP linking, allowing your mobile visitors to stay on an AMP version of your site once they land on any AMP page. The AMP plugin gives you the ability to install plugins that are not AMP compatible and then let them run only on the non-AMP version of your site. The plugin provides also support to make it easier for you to keep the total amount of CSS on any page under the 75 kilobytes limit imposed by AMP. And it does this by shaking the tree of CSS for a page and automatically removing as much unused CSS as possible. I hope that this brief overview gave you a good sense of the capabilities of the official AMP plugin for WordPress. The message that I want you to take home from this talk is this. With the capabilities of the AMP framework and the control mechanism it imposes, you can take advantage of the openness and flexibility of WordPress while minimizing the amount of resources you need to invest on developing and maintaining sites that bring great page experiences consistently to your users. Now, there are several ways to get started, learn more, and stay up to date with both the AMP project and the official AMP plugin for WordPress. Go ahead and download the plugin from the WordPress plugin repository. The AMP plugin is also part of the AMP project, and therefore it means that it's fully open source. You can follow its development and contribute if you would like to in GitHub. Check also the AMP plugin website, which has lots of information about the AMP plugin and cool stories to read. And also, make sure that you check the content of the AMP YouTube channel, including the brand new AMP in WordPress video series. Finally, I want to tell you, all the talks in AMP Fest are great, and I recommend them all. These particular three, I really enjoy them, and go next to them if you have a time. Pleasure to talk to you, and thank you.